Hey guys, welcome to my Facebook Live today. Today I will sound a bit different because I have a cold. So please bear with me. It will be maybe a bit adventurous. Nonetheless, I really want to do this live today because I have another important information for you, and it's regarding learned helplessness. So, you know, I actually encountered this phenomenon as a psychology student, and you know, at that time I really wasn't able to make the connection with its implications in our everyday life. But, you know, today I can really see how learned helplessness can impact your life and, you know, every aspect of it. You know, your relationships, your career, your business, or whatever you're doing and whatever is important to you. So what it actually is, what does it mean, and how it works? So learned helplessness was described by an American psychologist, Martin Seligman, and well, back then he actually used he conducted quite unethical experiment with dogs. So I'm not gonna describe that very thoroughly because you know, heads up to any dog lover who might be watching, it's really not that nice experiment. He actually used dogs and two groups of dogs and some negative or aversive stimuli, and well, the difference was that, you know, the first group was the first group of dogs was experiencing these negative stimuli, but they were able to escape, so they did. But the other group, they were exposed to some, you know, uncomfortable stimuli, and they were actually strapped in a harness, so they weren't able to escape. And, you know, once they learned that it's not possible to escape, they stopped trying even when the harness was not there anymore. So how does it work in our real life? Well, you know, it might happen even to us that if we are exposed to something uncomfortable or something really bad for some time, and we are not able to do something about it, we might, and we actually experience this helplessness, right? Because, you know, it's something really bad. We don't want to be exposed to it, but we kind of don't have the choice. You know, then over time, we might get kind of used to it or used to this inability to make a difference, to change the situation. So we kind of suffer. You know, we keep on being exposed, we keep on experiencing this negative situation, even though we don't have to do that, because the obstacle that was you know, kind of making it impossible to escape is no longer there. So, you know, I'm aware of the end of the year being really, really close. So I know that, you know, you will do some looking back and, you know, making plans for your next year. And I really hope that your next year will be better than this one, that, you know, it's going to be big and you're going to have, you know, an amazing time. And you know, I want to encourage you to check if there's not something similar to learned helplessness in your life, to kind of check if there isn't something you are kind of, you know, suffering or kind of trying to power through, and you don't have to do that anymore. Okay, so if there's anything in your life that is, you know, making you uncomfortable, if there's anything that you don't feel really good about, and you kind of came to, you know, this decision that, well, you're not able to do anything to make it stop. Well, maybe it's time to rethink that, or to check if you know, these negative conditions are still there, or if you can actually do something, if you can escape, or if you can turn it into something even better. So, you know, the trick here is that in that experiment I was talking before, you know, in order to make the dogs realize that they can escape, you know, they had to actually physically simulate the movements the dogs needed to do to escape the negative situation. So no threats, no treats worked, even demonstration. You know, they tried to, you know, they tried even showing the dogs how to escape. But unless they really physically took the dogs and showed them how to walk away from the negative stimuli, you know, they weren't able to change their behavior, and they had to do that at least twice. Okay? So if you want to get rid of your learned helplessness, if you're experiencing any, then you really need to do the movement. You really need to do the work, and you need to repeat it in order to realize, make yourself believe that you can really escape that. Okay? So if you want any help with realizing your, you know, where you might experience your own version of learned helplessness, then you know, let me know. We can chat about it and maybe find some ways how to overcome that, how to prepare yourself for the, you know, real exercise that will get you out of this funk. Because if there's no reason why you should stay there, well, then really don't. Okay, thank you for watching. Oh, thank you, Jessica, for being here. Yeah, thank you for your sympathies. My voice is really not very good. I had a workshop today, so I spoke for like 2 hours, and I have another one tomorrow, so I hope I won't lose my voice, you know, like totally. That would be really, really bad. Okay. Yeah. So thank you very much. As I already said, if you have any questions, if you have any interesting experience you'd like to share, just do it. I'll be glad to get in touch with you. Okay. Thank you very much. Have a great day, guys. It was awesome talking to you. I enjoyed that very much, despite my crackling voice. Okay, see you soon. Bye.